Hey folks, welcome to Market Intraday Analysis by InTheMoneyStocks.com, your leaders in pure technical analysis, avoiding all that Wall Street hype. This video for Tuesday, July 26th, 2011 is brought to you by Realtek. All right guys, markets are just slightly negative again. This is the second day in a row that we're kind of seeing this slight negative bias to the markets, and that's essentially because you have this overlaying debt issue in the U.S. We obviously have the budget concerns, the debt ceiling needs to be raised. Republicans and Democrats seem to be on two opposite aisles here, and that's creating a little minor uncertainty. Many people would have thought there was going to be a much bigger sell-off, but they have to understand that in general, the market still believes this debt deal will get done. In fact, it would be a shock to me personally if it didn't get done. And the reason why is because you're not going to have the markets go into default. Even if it's a day late, it's not going to be the end of the world as long as a deal gets done. And again, you still have another week basically to go till that August 2nd deadline. And as far as I've heard, the president can actually raise that debt ceiling if he needs to, invoke some sort of superiority play type move, in which case he can raise that debt limit even with the rest or without the rest of Congress behind him on that. So, I mean, there's so many outs here. The market is kind of saying, you know, listen, this is the facts. Let's go by the facts, not by emotion, not by hype, and focus on the markets. In the meanwhile, Dow Jones Industrial Average down 70 points, NASDAQ's actually up a half point, and the S&P 500 down 3. Now, why is the Dow leading the downside here? I mean, why is the Dow down on the day? The answer is simple, 3M. 3M had earnings, guys. This is down 30 points for the Dow, down $4.62, but if it's the Dow specifically, then you have to actually factor in 30 points on the Dow. So again, keep that in mind and watch that one very, very closely, folks, as it continues to be in play. All right, let me take a look at a couple other plays here. As you can see, 3M absolutely getting hammered on earnings. First of all, let's go back to the spiders and discuss the levels today. Intraday, there was a great scalp I called out in the intraday stock chat. It was right here. The markets fell down. Dual white trend lines mirroring the low pivot from yesterday. And actually, if you scan out and look larger, you can see the pivot high right here going back to the 20th. Pivot high, pivot high, pivot low. Therefore, that's going to be major support. I gave out the buy alert right there. Nailed the lows of the day on the charts, and we got a beautiful bounce up for profits on that trade. So good job there across the board to those in the intraday stock chat so far today. In addition, as the market has moved up here, you can see it hammered on the 200, had a small pullback, hammered on the 50, pulled back, excuse me, on the 20 right there, pulled back, consolidated, popped, and really ever since we got this initial down move and initial up move, the markets are just going sideways now. See how it's going up, down, up, and down? That's again telling you that the markets are all eyes right now on the debt ceiling kind of agreements here. What's going on here? Let's just watch this. The market's in quiet mode now. Volume has died out, 74 million on the SPY at a little after 1 p.m. Eastern time. All right, there are some other things in play today. We talked about 3M on earnings, but I want to take care of a few other stocks today. Baidu had earnings yesterday. That had a great move up today, although it's kind of just going sideways, but nonetheless a nice gap up there, up $7. Netflix had earnings that didn't quite meet Wall Street's expectations, even though the stock is off the lows, still down $21. Broadcom had earnings yesterday. That was good earnings there. That stock is trading up $3. You can see there's ups and downs. There's ups and downs in the earnings front here. And that, again, tells you that the market is neither getting a bullish tint off of earnings nor bearish. It's more the debt ceiling kind of uncertainty that's keeping this market on the downside. And again, it's just slight downside at this time in the markets. All right, if we take a look at the dollar is falling, and this is another culprit of the overall debt uncertainty here. If obviously we were to default, the dollar would come crashing down, so you're seeing a little bit of selling on anticipation. If there is a debt ceiling agreement made, you will see the dollar rally sharply higher for a day or two. So watch that very, very closely, folks, all right? And that should be something we all kind of pay attention to in the short run. GLD, gold, basically flat on the day. And again, gold has had a monster rally. If we go to the daily chart here, look at this move up. I mean, big move up in gold recently, so it's looking a little tired. I'd like to see, honestly, one more push up and then maybe take a short position if we get one more giant push up, maybe above 160. But again, if you're in the research center, you'll get that alert when I put it out if I do take the trade myself. And again, any trade that I do, folks, I'm going to put it out as a swing trade. If it's a swing trade, I'll put it out on the hot charts and alerts for you guys to see, all right? So again, we'll watch that very closely. SLV today is up 20 cents, basically a flat day on silver. And again, we're seeing a tiny bit of micro upside there, but not much. And then obviously the USO, which is actually an interesting play today. The USO sold sharply in the beginning of the day, but has come back. Look at this move up today, folks. Now it's coming down a little bit, but a very impressive move up. And again, one thing I've talked about to my premium members inside the Research Center, which again, anyone can be a Research Center member, take the free trial, that's fine as well. And it's a 7-day free trial. But notice how you have this upside move here and then choppy consolidation here. This is a bullish consolidation pattern, and I've been talking about this breaking out in the short term over the last 1 week session. Ever since we were really down here, I said I like it bullish as long as it does not close below this yellow little curly line right here, which is the 20 moving average. As long as it stays above that, this should go higher, and ultimately it's looking like that today. Beautiful reversal, making a move higher on oil. Oil's basically back to 100 bucks. In fact, it's over 100 now. So again, as you start to see oil move higher and higher, that's actually going to be a positive for solar and alternate energy, and also some of these smaller oil stocks that could be of interest as well, which I will be talking about in the intraday stock chat this afternoon. And we're going to look to play some of those if oil continues to move up in the coming days. So there's a lot of possibilities out there, folks, that we want to be aware of. We'll be watching very, very closely here on some of those. And again, there are plenty of trades out there to take. A couple stocks that I'm watching today, MCP, a big mover here, Moly Corp, rare earth plays going ballistic today to the upside. Moly Corp is up $4 on the day. Look at this move up today. All of a sudden taking off to the upside on Moly Corp. MCP is the symbol there. REE also having a nice day. Look at this move on REE, rare elements today. And that also brings me to my next point, which is a couple small Chinese plays to watch. SHZ up about 5%, 6% today. This is inching up. If you look at the daily chart, you can see it's at the low end of the chart recently here from a big run towards the end of the year here. And again, low end of the chart. So that, again, could break out. It needs to get above the 50 moving average. And then the other one that I like is CHGS, China Zhensheng Minerals, which, again, look at this move late last year. Consolidation low end of the chart. Again, this is definitely a possibility of a major mover in the short term. And again, the key is you have to see these rare earths continue up. But if these rare earths continue up, these plays, these Chinese plays, will go ballistic, folks. I mean, if they can run basically from $1.50 to $6 in late last year, this could easily go from $1.70, $1.75 here to well over $2. So I'm keeping those on my key watch list here. Intraday, I do have a little position in CHGS. I'm not sure if I'll hold it to the end of the day or through the end of the day as a swing. I'm not sure yet on it. I'm going to kind of watch and see how it trades. If it starts to uptick towards the end of the day, I'll probably hold it. If not, I'll probably move out and look to buy it again tomorrow if it looks good again tomorrow. And again, I'm very careful on holding things overnight in my day trading account. Right now, it's in my day trading. Ultimately, if it would be in my swing, if I looked at it as initially a swing. So we'll watch and see how that plays out. But nonetheless, watch these very closely. These are near parabolic possibilities, and you have to look with the MCP move, which is Moly Corp, with that type of move up, especially recently. Look at that ginormous move. If this continues, and probably short-term resistance is going to be up here at around 66.30, if that continues, then you definitely have upside potential here in some of these smaller plays as well. All right, so we'll watch very, very closely in the coming days on that. Let's go back to the SPY. SPY is down 40 cents. You're starting to fade a little bit here, which again, we want to see if we come back down to a double bottom. This would actually be a long scalp if we hit this level down here for a quick bounce. And if we get through that, the next level to watch, believe it or not, would be this little gap fill right down here. And that would be at 132.62. All right, 132.62. And again, we focus on price, pattern, and time here at In the Money Stocks, and we offer a free trial to the Research Center, free trial to the Intraday Stock Chat. It's a 1 week, 7 day free trial. Come join, check us out, make money, and belong with us for life. And again, that's what our members do here. They're with us for life because we're going to give them everything. We're going to educate them. We're going to give them proprietary analysis. We're going to give them trades, no losers in the hot charts and alerts in over a month. It's the way it's done, folks. All right. In any case, let's go over to a couple other things here on the spiders. We can obviously see the action there as it's slowly inching down here in the early afternoon period. Goldman Sachs is actually having a continued good day. I love this chart for a couple reasons, and I don't like it as a buy now. It's too late. But I have to say, it makes me proud. I tell our members every single day, and I talk to people, and I give lectures and such, and I say, listen, news is secondary. Don't buy news. News will get you on the wrong side of the trade. And many people say, oh, you know, I don't understand, but if I hear good news, isn't it a buy? I say, no, it's not. And a good example would be Goldman Sachs. Goldman Sachs had negative earnings. They missed earnings estimates here, folks. They missed earnings estimates right here. And on the day it missed earnings estimates, it gapped down to this level. That was at 125.80. Now, my partner, Chief Market Strategist Nick Santiago, had a key level there as a major buying opportunity. So again, it would be contrary to the thought process. If you're listening to news, you're probably scared to enter it there. Oh man, they just missed earnings. This is bad. Ultimately, look at the chart. The low of the day was there. The amateurs dumping there or going short. The chart rips up. And basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 green candles in a row to the upside. Truly remarkable, guys. So again, ignore the news. I know it seems counterintuitive, but the news will get you into trouble. Focus on the price, the pattern, and the time. And we can teach you all that here at In the Money Stocks, in the Research Center, in the chat room. And again, learn how to make money in any market. Up, down, sideways, doesn't matter. There's always a trade to be had if you know what to look for. All right, folks. Enough said. That was my little educational piece for the day on Goldman Sachs. Have a great rest of the day. And don't forget to come join the Research Center free trial, chat room free trial. I'll see you later.